In a recent Nature article, you addressed the issue of climate change communication. What exactly is the point you want to make?
The scientific community should do much more and much better when it comes to informing people about climate change, in particular people with low levels of literacy.
Can you explain this?
Well, there is a worldwide shift in all media towards more and more accessible, simple visual information, also in the field of climate change. Films, documentaries, media campaigns, comic strips, computer games, apps, virtual and mixed reality applications. Climate change is just a playground for visualization. But all this visual stuff, this visual technology, does not bridge the gap, the huge information divide between the literate world on the one hand and people who are not or hardly able to read and write. That's the problem. And we do not realize enough that people who are not able to read and write, that they are not able either to read visual messages.
Can you give a simple example?
Well, take this very simple health instruction. You see here an arrow going from left to right. Everyone should know, okay, this is a situation left who should result in the situation right. But that's not easy. That's something that is a convention. We take it as a convention that this arrow has this meaning of consequence. But you have to learn it, just like you have to learn the word consequence, to write the word consequence. Or take a more culturally adapted for examples. You have a tree here. Why should you recognize this as a tree if you live in an environment where trees look completely different? And how should you understand the message of this pictogram of deforestation? So that's the type of things that we should realize as a research community, that there is much research needed to know more about the level of knowledge that people have in parts of the world with low levels of literacy. Well, I think we have to learn from other sciences. Health sciences, they have much more experience with low literate audiences and basic information on health issues. There are journals with interest in these issues, health communication journals. We should do the same for climate change, because climate change is equally important compared to health. And what we should do more is to set up research aimed at developing and testing basic visual information on climate change. It is research which is not so popular, because you really have to go to very local communities, and that's difficult. You cannot use all your fancy methodologies, eye tracking and all kinds of stuff, because it's all very basic. People themselves are not able to use methodologies for which you need literacy skills. They cannot even fill in a simple survey. So it's not popular, but it's very much needed for them to develop adequate communication stuff, but also for us to be aware more about the huge divide between the literate world and their levels of knowledge.
So we can assume that low literate people will not understand this interview?
I'm sure they will not, because they are really low in literacy, and we really should learn more from them in terms of what they know and how we can adapt communication to these communities in a way that they understand, because it's not their problem, it's our problem. We should be more aware of their problem, and we should put in more research effort.